If you ever touch a butterfly and you look at your finger, you might see some dust. That's actually the scales on the butterfly wings. Any touch or rubbing of my skin can cause a blister or the skin to tear. So it's very sensitive, just like a butterfly's wings are. My name is Paul Martinez, and I have epidermolysis bullosa, which is also known as EB. I grew up in Stockton, California. Majority of my family is here, and it's an okay place to live.
Epidermolysis bullosa is a family of inherited blistering skin diseases characterized by skin fragility, often blistering and scarring, with an increased predisposition to both infection as well as developing certain skin cancers in some subtypes.
The underlying cause of EB is the absence of a particular protein that is holding the skin together, so that you can think of it as like a molecular glue.
When you talk to the patients with this condition and the families and the caregivers, it just breaks your heart.
It's very frustrating for the patient, the family. It's also frustrating for the physicians and the other members of the medical team, because we can't cure the disease.
A lot of EBs, you know, they're in wheelchairs or they have G-tubes to help eat. They're very small and fragile. Where it relates to me, I do have problems swallowing and eating sometimes, but I get throat dilation surgeries to help open my throat. I was actually born with normal hands, but over time they curl up and fuse together into like a ball. So it makes it very difficult to do basic things in life. On Mondays and Wednesdays and Fridays, I do bandage changes, which my mother helps me with. That process can take anywhere from 2 to 2.5 hours. It's a very tedious and grueling process. My mother is definitely my rock. She does, you know, everything for me, and there's no way that I could pay her back for that. The word pain itself doesn't even describe how bad EB is. Your body is constantly on fire. It burns from the wounds from raw flesh, and it keeps repeating over and over and over. The cycle is never ending. Pain is my life. It's my reality. It's my normal. In a weird way, it's like my best friend. We've known each other since day one of life. If anyone has a legitimate excuse to take pain medication, it would be people with EB. One of the reasons why I don't take it is because I'd rather feel the pain to not feel nothing, because the day that I feel nothing to me is the day that I know that something's seriously wrong.
What we hope to be able to achieve, and what we've been working at Stanford to achieve, is delivering a normal copy of the gene to EB patient cells, and then using those cells, which are now expressing the normal gene, to make skin tissue and put that back on the patient.
I got 6 grafts done. I go back to Stanford about every 3 months to get them checked to see how they're doing, and at this stage, just to see if everything is looking good so far. Why me? I used to ask that question every single day of my life. Since the day I was born, there is no second that goes by that I know what normal feels like. When I was born, you know, I wasn't even expected to live. They said my last prayer over me, a priest in the hospital. But I'm 32 years of age. In terms of EB, that's pretty old.
We do believe that the insights that have been gained from this first phase one trial will inform the next step of research. We can start to see on the horizon the potential to really make a difference for patients affected with EB.